strength overflows. My cup of success overflows. My cup of prosperity overflows. Say, my cup of excellence overflows. There is grace for the journey.
Accepting Jesus and living for Him. Hallelujah. And I speak into your life this morning. For every wasted life, God will replenish. Hallelujah. For every wasted life, God will restore. Hallelujah. I want you to lift your hands this morning unto the heavens. And thank God this morning for your life. I want us to thank God so much. The greatest miracle in one's life is to go to bed and wake up the next morning. The greatest miracle in your life, the greatest miracle in my life, is to go to bed and wake up the next morning. Hallelujah. That is the greatest miracle. And this morning I want you to thank God for giving you life. Life is short. He has given you life and He has given you in abundance because you have Jesus. He who has Jesus has life and has it abundantly. You want to thank God? Open your mouth and thank God this morning. Close your eyes, focus on God, and thank you for the life you are living. Some of us do not go to hospital. When you fall sick, the only thing you do is you take some paracetamol and you're okay. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Libro Sakaya Braka Pati Pibreki Kanda Baba. Libro Sakaya Baba Baba Bose Lebek Branda. Libro Sakaya Bada Baba Sakaya Bada Baba. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Libro Sakaya Bada Baba. In the name of Jesus. Father, this morning we are gathered under your feet. Said unto Jesus, whom shall we go to? Whom shall we go to? Because thou hast the words of eternal life. We have no one to run to, Lord. We have nobody to run to. We have no one to go to. And we will come unto you, O Lord, because it is you who has the words that give eternal life. This morning we come before you, Lord, to speak to us. We come before you, Lord, to teach us. We come before you, Lord, to rebuke us. We come before you, Lord, to correct and instruct us. And to perfect us, Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus, let our hearts, let our spirit, let our minds be reset. And we see of you. Holy Spirit, brood over me this morning. And let your word be heard in power. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, for 2 minutes, I just want you to lift your voice and speak in tongues this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus. The prayer warriors, you can take the microphone and begin to speak in tongues. Jesus, rise up on your feet. Lord, rise up on your feet, such as I saw in the name of Jesus. Lord, God, you both shut up. Come on. Jesus. Beloved, listen to me. There is a call for everything. Hallelujah. When we gather before God, there is a call. There is a call for every meeting to begin. There is a call for authority to be established and for power to rule and take dominance. Hallelujah. And for the church, the quorum is two or more. Hallelujah. The quorum is two or more. For the power of God to be demonstrated in the church. For the hand of God to rule in the church. For the authority of God to be established in the church. The quorum is two or more. Hallelujah. Amen. And we are more than two. We are more than two. We are more than two. Jesus said, wherever two or more are gathered, I am there in your midst. Beloved, God is here. This morning, the power of God is here. I don't want you to be a spectator. God be an spectator. Come down for me. Hold on for me. Don't be an spectator.
Violence.
And it is the violence that takes it by force. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look. Don't look at what is around you. Don't look at the empty chairs around you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look unto your God. David said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. Lift up your eyes unto the hills, because that is where your help cometh from. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning, I want you to lift your voice and talk to God. I don't know the threats you are facing. I don't know the challenges you are facing. But let me tell you one thing. That every challenge that you are facing is an opportunity for you to be blessed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please listen and listen carefully.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Bible says in Judges that Samson was going to get married. And on his way to ask for the woman's hand in marriage with his parents, Bible says that a lion confronted him. A lion. It was a threat. It was a challenge. Hallelujah. But Bible says that the Holy Spirit came mightily upon Samson and he devoured the lion. It is my prayer that God will empower you. That God will strengthen you.
Amen.
That every lion, every threat in your life, you will overcome.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Bible went on to say, sometime later, when the marriage has been performed and Samson was taking the wife home, he went to where he devoured the lion. And in the carcass of the lion was honey.
Amen.
In the carcass of the lion that was coming to devour him.
Jeez.
Was a war. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Embedded in your threat is only for you to enjoy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I pray that God will give you courage.
Yes, Lord.
To face every threat that comes your way.
Amen.
Look, when the threat comes your way, have the eyes of David. David saw Goliath not as a threat. He saw it as an opportunity.
Yes,
to his blessing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I tell you this morning, every threat you are facing this morning is an opportunity for you to be blessed.
Amen.
Face it. Face it in the name of Jesus. And you overcome it.
Amen.
Lift your voice and talk to God. The Father, give me courage. Give God a mighty clap offering in this place. in the sound of praise. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. 2 Timothy chapter 3 in the verse 16. Bible says that all scripture is given by inspiration. Hallelujah. All scripture is given by inspiration of God. And is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. That the man of God may be perfect. Hallelujah. All scripture is given by a pastor, a bet church. So if there is something that you don't know, the word of God will teach you. Hallelujah. And it's my prayer that the word of God will teach you today. Anything that you don't know, anything you are asking questions about, the word of God this morning will give you answers. Amen. And it says that it comes to reproof, it comes to rebuke. Hallelujah. And this is one aspect that when you come to church, we don't like. Say, also for preaching, I say, no, a true unique cry. Only I am pet. Hallelujah. But you see, I have come to realize that that is the best aspect. Hallelujah. Amen. Say, amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, come, you know, say, maybe I will call. And fail you. So there is a need for you to change your ways. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it is my prayer that you be receptive. That when it comes to you as a rebuke, you will accept it. Amen. If it comes to me preaching as a rebuke, I will accept it. Hallelujah. Because as I talk to you, as I preach you, the word also applies to me. Hallelujah. And I must work on myself if there is something that the word of God is telling me. Praise God. Because it will perfect me. It is profitable. Praise God. And it says that it comes to correct us. It comes to correct you. Say, oh yeah, dear. I am a bet your soul. And you see, by you see. Amen. And it comes to instruct us. So this morning, you receive the word of God in several dimensions. Probably it will come to teach you, or it will come to rebuke you, or come and instruct you, or to come and correct you. Hallelujah. If you're happy to hear this, give a clap offering unto the Lord. Amen. We are in a month of Rehoboam's connection. Hallelujah. And it is about relationship. Amen. Relationship in the sense of family, relationship in the sense of marriage, relationship in the sense of, you know, church, anything relationship that you can think about. Whenever two people come together, there's a relationship. Amen. Probably it's not a relationship unto marriage, a relationship related to, you know, family or anything, but anytime myself and Mr. Hamad, we are together, there's a relationship because we are two. Hallelujah. So this month we are taking time to talk about relationships, to pray concerning relationships and all that, and expect that God will bless us. Hallelujah. Amen. So this morning God is giving us a very wonderful word. Hallelujah. A very, very wonderful word. And the word is the power of unity. The power of unity. Hallelujah. And this cuts across every relationship. It cuts across every relationship. Amen. The absence of unity is trouble. Wherever there is no unity, there is trouble. That is the only thing you can see. There is confusion. Nothing works. And unity is no respecter of persons. Amen. It is no respecter of persons. Any group of people who decides to, you know, welcome relationship, unity will come. Amen. Any group of people, if God decides that, one is sumo, it could make fame more and you will hear, it could make fame more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If Akans and Elwes decide that we want there to be unity amongst us, unity will come. If a male and a female decide that we want there to be unity amongst us, unity will come. So unity is no respecter of persons, it's no respecter of race, it's no respecter of gender. We are Ba, we are Bema, we are Franfreni, we are Beni, we are Kreni, we are Kreni. Now see, you perceive, Babu, you are Eba, you are Dema, Ebeba. Hallelujah. And one other thing is that unity achieves every intended result. All things being equal. Every intended result, unity is able to achieve it. Whether it is a good thing or a bad thing, whether you are united, if you are united, you will achieve it. Hallelujah. If all of us seated here come together and say that we want to sweep the whole of this compound, it is a good thing, right? Once we have come together and decided and united to do it, we will do it. If you also come together and say that, God forbid, let's go to this house and rob them. Once we are united, we will find every means and go there and rob them. So unity, whether it is for a good purpose or for a bad purpose, once you are united, you will achieve your intended results. Hallelujah. Amen. Put your hands together unto the Lord. And so, families are struggling. Marriages are struggling. Businesses are struggling. Even the church is struggling because there is no unity. Amen. Unity is not as it is here together like this. Say, Yabana, Yetina, Sidia, Yetina. That's not unity. Hallelujah. You can be sitting here, but it is each one for himself. Amen. That is no unity. And marriages are struggling because husband and wife are not united. The only time you see them united in appearance is when they go to public space, because they have to see them as couples, husband and wife. Amen. Some of us, sorry, and they couldn't or they never know. And they say, Musa, amen. Let them go home. Let siblings gather. And you see, there is no unity. Let the family gather. The church, there is no unity. Amen. And this is the heartbeat of God. It is the heartbeat of God that we would dwell as one people. That unity would reside in our midst as a people. Praise the Lord. So Jesus Christ prayed for us. In fact, it is the longest recorded prayer of Jesus in scripture. John chapter 17. John chapter 17 from the verse 9 to 11. Jesus prayed. And this prayer is divided into four sessions. Jesus prayed for himself. He prayed for his disciples. The disciples, you know, he was with us at that time. He prayed for them on two occasions. And then prayed for all believers. And this is the prayer he prayed for believers. That includes you and I. He said, and I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me. For they are thine. And all mine are thine. And thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. Verse 11. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to thee. Holy Father, keep through thy own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are one. Hallelujah. Jesus said to the Father that I am not in this world, but they are in the world. You and I are in the world. Until Jesus comes and takes us back, we reside in the world, remain in the world. And Jesus prayed for this, said, Father, keep them. And it is my prayer that they will be one are one. The popular scripture, John 10:30. I and my Father are one. Hallelujah. And this was a heartbeat of Jesus Christ, that he prayed this prayer five times. This request, he made it five times. When you read through verse 21 to 23, Jesus always prayed that they may be one, that they may be one as we are one, that they may be one as we are one. And I was asking myself questions, that why is that Jesus want us to be one? And I went to Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. And I saw something there. They said leadership by example, right? Leadership by example. So I realized that God, the Father, God, the Son, and God, the Holy Spirit, there is unity amongst them. Hallelujah. That is why we have the Trinity. The Trinity is made up of Nyameja, Nyameoba, and then Nyameden. Hallelujah. So this is leadership by example. And God wants us to emulate Him. Emulate the Trinity. Emulate how they are united and do things in common. Praise the Lord. So there is a display of unity in the Trinity. So in 1 John chapter 5, verse 7, the Bible says, there are three that bears record in heaven: the Father, the Word, and the Spirit. And these three are one. Hallelujah. There are three that bear record in heaven. Nyama miensa anedi adansiye ewoso. Eta, Eba, ene unkonku. And these three are one. Amen. It doesn't make sense to say that three people will come together and be one. In number, when myself, Minister Hammond, Minister Isaac come together, we are standing. There's no way we are one. In number we are three. Hallelujah. But it will only make sense in unity. Praise the Lord. I hope you are getting me. It will only make sense in unity that we are one, though we are three in number, but in unity we are one. Praise the Lord. So there is unity displayed in the Trinity. Two, there is unity displayed in creation. Before God created the heavens and the earth, unity came to display. Hallelujah. Amen. Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. The God we see there in Hebrew is Elohim. Hallelujah. Amen. And Elohim is a plural form of God. Amen. So it depicts the Trinity. Praise the Lord. So in the beginning, Elohim, which stands for God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, created the heaven and the earth. So creation even came to be by unity. If where we are living was founded on the foundations of unity, then we cannot do away with unity. Praise the Lord. In the earth we are living in, assassina yet sisuno. Say a number who you soon yet people assassina. Not baku yolo yet me a ye free and problem. Praise the Lord. In the beginning, assassino, nyamija, nyamyoba, nyamu conquer ebo so any assassin. Any dear woman now. Praise the Lord. And it will interest you to know that the sea, the land, the moon, the stars, the sun, everything we see are in unity. They are united. Praise the Lord. Other than that, when the sea decides to say, make what excursion was as this one, there is trouble. Other than that, if the sun says, look, I won't rise up, there will be trouble. So they understand what they are supposed to do. The sun understands the responsibilities and the duties of the moon. So they are united. So when it is time for the sun to come, the moon will give way and the sun will come. When it's time for the moon to come, the sun will give way. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And three, there is display of unity in the creation of man. Hallelujah. There is display of unity. Genesis 1:26. And God said, let us make man. And God said, let us make man. So you can say, God the Father said to God the Son and the Holy Spirit, let us make man. Let us make man. So they came together, they decided and created you and me. So if we were created, if what we are living on was created based on unity, and we were also created based on unity, then we can't live out unity. There is nothing you can take unity out from that will work. I tell you what, open your beer, put your extreme eye, human die. It won't work. It will seem as if it is working, but no, it is not. It is not. In the end, you will know that it is not working. Hallelujah. And God displayed again unity in what we call relationship. We say when two people come together, it's a form of relationship. So the first relationship God instituted, marriage, it was based on unity. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 2, 24. Genesis 2. Let me take from 20, from 23 to 24. And Adam said, this now is bone of my bones. Hallelujah. And flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. 24. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Hallelujah. Unity. Praise the Lord. So the first relationship established was established on unity. Hallelujah. So there is no relationship you can take unity out from. Amen. Nobody is an island. Nobody. And an island does not even exist on itself. What makes an island an island? Water bodies around it. Amen. A water body is something. Hallelujah. So if there's no water body, there's no island. Praise the Lord. Are you getting it? If there's no water body, there's no island. So nobody is an island. How do we call island a tree? Island. Without the water body, there's no island. So don't see yourself as an island. You will miss it. Hallelujah. You will miss it. So it was the heartbeat of Jesus that there will be unity amongst us. The heavens and the earth was formed on unity. The Trinity are one. Man was created based on unity. Relationship, unity. So there's nothing you can leave, you can take unity out from. Hallelujah. And you see, God is a wise God. He gave man a very practical example. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. He gave man a very practical example. He didn't take anything outside. He didn't want to go anywhere to carry anything and say, man, look onto this thing and be conscious of the fact that there should be unity among you. There should be unity in the marriage, unity among siblings, unity among family, unity in the church. No, God did not go anywhere. God used me. He used a human body for me to understand how important it is for brethren to dwell in unity. So as I stand here, my body is one, but I have many parts. Many parts make up my body. Many people are here, but now I'm praying, and I'm many people are here. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 12. First Corinthians 12 and the verse 12. Says, for as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ. I'll take it again, sorry. For as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body. Second, you put your air back up. I want pass the brain. Some pass the brain ever together. Ever yet back up. Hallelujah. So God gave us, He used us as a practical example for us to know how important it is for us to dwell in unity. My head cannot get up and say, look, today I am going to Nima. And my leg will say, no, I am going to Kaswa. Just imagine. Say, I'm not paying you, sorry for you, get this, no. When he said, no, me and be. Now, I saw, I can say, and also me, see, I see, yeah. Now, when I can say, my smell is some jollof. It's the person they call, then I say, ah, for the way. May they call him out. Just imagine the confusion. Are we getting the picture? So you have many parts. The head cannot get up and say that I don't need the neck. The hand cannot get up and say I don't need the legs. No. The eyes cannot get up and say I am the eye. So look, ears. See somewhere. Never. Like you wouldn't have been here this morning. Imagine all your different parts wanted to do something separately. There is nothing that will work. There will be chaos. Your nose is here, your ears is there, your leg is there. Every part is somewhere. Where will you be? The body is only complete when all the members come together. The marriage is only complete when husband and wife are together. Siblings are complete when they are together. The family is complete when they are together. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God gave us, He used the human body as an example. Imagine your eyes when you yell, yeah. What happens to your whole body? Do you say it is my eye? So the rest of the body, feel free and walk. It affects the entire body. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Put your hands together unto the Lord. So God has given us a very practical example. And we must live by that. Amen. Now I want to move on to what is it about unity? I think it's that you come from everywhere. One, Genesis chapter 11, verse 1 to 4. Genesis 11, 1 to 4. Said, and the whole earth was of one language and of one speech. Amen. We will come back to this. And the whole earth was of one language and of one speech. And it came to pass as they journeyed from the east, that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. And they set one to another. And they said one to another, go, let us make break. Hallelujah. So Bible says, after the flood, the whole earth was with one language. Hebrew, they were speaking Hebrew. One language. And they decided to settle at a place. And when they settled, they called a meeting. Hallelujah. And they engaged themselves in a discourse. And they said, they took a decision. Let us make break. Let's continue. And said, and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone, and slime they had for mortar. Verse 4. And they said, go to, let us build us a city and a tower, whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. So they came together and took a decision. Let us make brick, and it was done. Let us make a tower, and it was done. Let us build a city, and it was done. Hallelujah. Wherever there is unity, there is vision. Praise the Lord. Bible says they had one language and one speech. So when they came together, when they sat at meeting, look, there are some meetings there, it never ends. We have concluded on that day. Praise the Lord. But they were of one language and one speech. Hallelujah. It doesn't mean they didn't have different views. Amen. Sitting at a meeting does not mean that all of us must have one view. No. That is not the essence of meetings. When we sit, we express our views. But in the end, there is one view we go with. And it will only come to be when there is unity. Hallelujah. So these people were united. So when they said, let us make brick, they made it. Let us make slime, they made it. Let us build a city, they made it. Let us make a tower, they made it. And they advanced. When you meet, are you able to conclude on issues? Obia your girl. The husband is your girl. The wife is your girl. When siblings meet, the ones cut a crown on a chest and meet the SM of fire. Hallelujah. And nothing works. When you are not united, there is no vision. Families are wallowing in poverty. Families have been scattered. There is no vision. There is no vision. Everybody is of himself. Everybody is of herself, and they are doing their own thing. Because when they come together as a family to talk, nothing works. Say, I'm from Asama. There be. When you say, I am from Asama, there be. Now meet you, confusion. Hallelujah. Yeah. But when there is unity, there is vision, there is focus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. Wherever there is unity, we don't hesitate in taking or making decisions. No. When we meet here as leaders, all of us have different views. Reverend will bring something. And we all share our views, but in the end, we take one and we all give our support. Hallelujah. Yeah. That is the power of unity. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. That is the power of unity. Two, unity brings progress. Genesis 11, 6. He said, and the Lord said, behold, the people is one. The teachers here, or the grammarians here. The people is one. Why can you speak this English? But God spoke this English. Hallelujah. And he is using it to demonstrate how important it is. How the people were united. They were united in everything. Hallelujah. So united. So he said, the people is one. He doesn't see two. He doesn't see three. He doesn't see four. He sees one. Many people together, but he sees one. But the people is one. And he said, and they have all one language. And this they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do. Nothing can be restrained from a united front. When the family is united, there is progress. There is nothing you put your hands to, all things being equal, that will not work. Praise the Lord. There is nothing. The people is one. Is the church one? Is the church one? We have agreed to tie the place. Are we one to tie the place? We have agreed to come for morning devotions. Have we agreed to come? If you will progress as a church, if you progress as couples, if you progress as a family, if you progress as a nation, the people must be one. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If you want to progress, unity, married man, married woman, husband, wife, if you want your marriage to be sweet, unity. Hallelujah. And I sat down and I went into my closets and I asked myself questions regarding my marriage. Say, do I keep some things for my wife? If I keep things from her, why do I do that? Hallelujah. I know men don't want to tell their wives their salary. Is it right? Husbands, you find it difficult to tell your wives your salary will end. Amen. Because you think, Charlie, yes, but I came to realize that it is good for your wife to know how much you earn. Because it helps in planning. Hallelujah. Because if you don't disclose the time that you don't have, your wife thinks you have. Because she doesn't know how much you earn. Equally, the women, they don't tell. And they don't. Hallelujah. But we must know. I don't think husband should hide anything from the wife. And the wife should hide anything from the husband. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah. So that we can enjoy our marriage. Amen. Siblings are hiding things from themselves. And they confide in others than their family members. If you can't trust your own brother and your own sister, you trust somebody outside. Do you know what is going on in that person's family? Amen. Yeah. They say, you see, Bokosama, we need to know. What is his name? Eh? The devil you know is. I don't know if that is true. But I find sense in it. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Why should I wash my clothes outside? I prefer to wash it outside. Hallelujah. Than to wash it inside. Seven years old, baby. No, I am not. Men pet. Men pet so be full from. Hallelujah. Amen. Unity is very important. So where there is unity, there is progress. Where there is no unity, there is no progress. And siblings are suffering because unity did not start from marriage. Sometimes if we see, say that most of times, because the father is telling this, the mother is also telling someone that. So there's unity. And our papa, and our mommy, and our papa. So there's division. And a kingdom that is divided by itself will not stand. It will not stand. Anything that does not stand falls. Anything that falls cannot rise and progress. Hallelujah. So unity must dwell in our midst. Amen. Three. Unity brings good reward. Hallelujah. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9. It brings good reward. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praye, do you know how to sing?
Yeah.
Praye owe, can we sing it? Praye owe, praye owe, uyi bakwa ebu, ukabo ma ebu. Enyanume na yemba kwanke ye. Hallelujah. Yena yemba kwa eye. Unity brings good reward because of synergy. What is synergy? Said your prayer, you will me you pray back up. Now me they pray. Bra, me brema. And son, I'm a pray. I have prayed you. And tell my good job. Hallelujah. But me come home. Now me pray. I go fast. Maybe within shortest possible time. Hallelujah. So when husband and wife come together, there is good reward. What I will use my salary per hour with the bayon, the one they did the camera, it can achieve a lot. What me met nasa met dream, me why they can money a dream, we can find solution at the quickest possible time. Hallelujah. So unity brings good reward. Ecclesiastes 4:9. Who is there? So let's start there. Please read for me. You are not there.
Two are better than one.
Two are better than one.
Because they have a good reward
because
for their labor.
They have a good reward to do what?
For their labor.
For their labor. Why do you want to labor alone? All of us working in government institutions. Afra, an accountant. Ask him if he can do everything in the office. You cannot do it. You can't do it. I need the hand. The hand needs the head. The head needs the legs. The legs need the eye. We need everybody to come on board so that there will be synergy. When there is synergy, we don't waste our energy. Hallelujah. When there is synergy, the little effort we put in, we achieve a lot. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So unity brings good reward. Praya oi, uyi bakwa ebebu. Ukaboma ebu. Unity brings strength. In unity, there is strength. Hallelujah. In unity, there is strength. Ecclesiastes 4, I think 12.
If one prevails against him,
if one prevails against me,
two shall withstand him.
Two will stand him.
And a threefold cord is not quickly broken.
A threefold cord is not quickly broken. When you are one, you will be broken. When you want to do it all by yourself, you will be broken. You will be broken. How much energy do you have? the example. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I need you and you need me. You think Reverend can do this all by himself? No. You think I can do this all by myself? No. None of us here. So you can't do it alone. If you God realize that, God, so he displays unity in the Trinity. So when we come together, there is strength. When we come together, there is support. Ecclesiastes 4, 9 to 10. There is support, there is protection. I hold you and you hold me and we move. You support me. When I'm falling, you pull me up. When you are falling, I will pull you up. We move together. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So my brother, my sister, my mother, my father, you need your husband. Husband, you need your wife. Brother, you need your sister. Sister, you need your brother. You need your uncle, you need your auntie. Yes, he's a witch, that's what they say. Do your part as a Christian. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And leave the rest for God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Bible says, suffer not a witch to live. So if the person is a witch, you are praying your prayer. That's why you must always be on fire. So pray your prayer. If it's a witch, God will deal with him. God will deal with her. But you need everybody. Hallelujah. Without a father, there's no family. Without a mother, there's no family. Without a sibling, there's no family. Hallelujah. Sometimes when we go to our villages, in our say, we should end it. So, uncle, we cry. And my yaba cry, we cry. Say, you call your cross here. And you say, we should end it. Hallelujah. At times, it's this year, seven, no, be major academy. In an academy, not on one year old. I am mobile. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So look, you cannot be an island. Sadly, if you imagine, you can't. You can't. An island needs water bodies. An island needs vegetation, needs trees to be on it, to make it an island. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Wow, our time is fast spent. Let's move on. The next one. Unity provides a platform for answering prayers. Hallelujah. Matthew 18, verse 19. Can we read that one very fast? Matthew 18, 19. If anybody is there, can read for me, please.
Again, I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth, as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven.
Amen. Again, I say unto you that if two of you shall agree, how can two work together unless they agree? If two of you will come together, so unity provides a platform for answered prayer. So, wife, do you know why your prayers are not being answered? Husband, do you know why your prayers are not being answered? Brother, sister, cousin, auntie, whatever. Do you know why your prayers are not being answered? This could be a reason. Because if a man therefore shall leave his mother and father and will cleave unto the wife and they will be one flesh, and I don't agree with my wife, and there is tension between my wife, do you think when I pray, God will hear me? No. So he provides a platform. If daughter, you don't respect your father, don't respect your mother, you think God will hear your prayers? Forget it. Amen. So we must be united. How do we live in unity? How do we ensure there's unity? One, we must have one language and one speech. Hallelujah. That means we must have one mind. One mind. And as I said earlier, it will be difficult for us to have one mind. That is reality. Because whenever we meet, then you know your different views. Hallelujah. But in the end, we must conclude on one. We must conclude on one. There's a saying, let's agree to what? To disagree. Is the opposite right? Eh? Let's disagree to agree. Is it right? So whenever there's an issue and we all have diverse opinions, let us agree to disagree so that we won't fight. Hallelujah. We know so, yeah, and we move on. In that, there will be unity. Genesis 11:1. And the people had one language. Wife, husband, have one language. Inculcate that into your children. Let's inculcate that into the church. When the family is one, the church will be one. Hallelujah. Because it is the basis. If husband and wife, children come together united, we form the church. So if my wife and my children, we are united,